Wonderful. Thanks so much. Let me see if I can raise this a little bit. I'm Mark O'Connor, and it's great to be here. And thanks for sharing this night with us during pre-Mardi Gras. Or is it officially Mardi Gras? Or we saw some parades out there. Man, fantastic to be here this time of year. And that was a fairly new piece I composed, and it was written for Captain Blackbeard's ship and the discovery of it just recently, a few years ago, off the coast of North Carolina. For years, there's been speculation that that ship was lost at sea 300 years ago, and they found it in about 25 feet of water off the Outer Banks. This whole time, you know, we've been snorkeling right above it, and it's just right down there. So I came up with this new kind of string playing. I call it pirate fiddling, and you heard a fine example of that right there.
They are good pirates.
Very good pirates. Arg! It's like a musical, you know, that is arg put to music. And the chase on the high seas. So that's very descriptive music, and sometimes the composition can be fairly programmatic like that, and I kind of do both. This next piece is called the Improvised Violin Concerto, and it's, for me, it's kind of wide open. I'm going to make up my entire solo line. So I've orchestrated the piece, and compositionally, the orchestra carries the themes and thematic development. And so I don't have to worry about that. I could join them at times, but I can improvise it when I do. I could tass it, you know, hang out for a while, just listen, come back in. And what I'm going to do to enhance the musical experience for me, I've got some electronics that I'm going to introduce during the piece. So when you're improvising, you want to be able to play at all times. So when the brass back there is playing at forte, I want to be able to kind of match them, so I've got to lift my volume so they don't have to quiet down for me. So I've got some electronics and an amp, so you're going to hear me play acoustically, then electronically, all with this beautiful wooden violin. The Improvised Violin Concerto, we're going to do the two final movements of the five, and it's based on the essential elements, the mysterious fifth element in this equation is faith, human intervention into the elements. So we're going to hear earth and then faith for the Improvised Violin Concerto. Take it away, Sean. Thank you.
Thank you.
Dr. Jean asked me to speak a little bit, but I wanted to ask Nadja to say something about our collaboration on this piece. I wrote it for Nadja it's been almost 20 years ago. And she inspired this composition. Sometimes when you're a composer, you write it after, you know, one day you're writing for a pirate ship, and the next day, you know, one of the greatest classical violinists of our time, you know. So it's a mixed bag out there. And it's been a really rewarding experience for me to share music in this way. And I was just curious, Nadja, you know, I mean, you've had so many years to think about our collaboration on this piece and everything. And do you often play double violins with many folks? And is it always a challenge, or is this a unique experience? Or?
I played double violin with some of my students in my last concert here, which was a lot of fun. Yeah. But this is the challenge for me in this piece, besides the notes that he wrote, is you know, he's like one of the greatest jazz fiddlers ever, and I'm not. That's about it. So I had to try to, you know, I'm sort of faking it. But hopefully, no. You know, the piece is great. We're starting with the slow movement, and then we're going to the first movement. But the reason why we wanted to play the first movement is because the cadenza is really masterful. He just did an amazing job at integrating his style, my style, and bringing it together. And so let's just play this piece. Let's do it. Yeah.
Thank you. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's Mardi Gras hat. One more? It's good. It's fast. Fast one. Be over in a jiff.